Hello, hello. This is Adam with Tri-State Live at South by Southwest, and I'm joined by fellow Pennsylvanian, Lancastrian, Philadelphian, Dennison Whitmer. How's it going, Dennison?
That's going great. Thanks. Thanks for asking me to come over.
Yeah. So this is not your first South by Southwest. You've been here a few times. So, you know, how would you describe it to someone who's never been here before?
Well, it's totally insane. I was trying to describe it to my wife last night over the phone, and I was talking to her walking down the street, and I was like, I'm in a sea of people, and she's like, well, what do you mean by sea of people? I was just like, everywhere I look, it's like, you know, music type people out of every, you know, yeah. Like spilling out of every building, you know, music going everywhere. So it's, I don't even know how to describe it other than pure insanity, I guess.
So when did you play your first show here? Like, what year was it?
It would have been about like 5 years ago or 6 years ago. I played for like 3 years in a row, and then I took a couple of years off, and then decided to come back this year because I have a new album coming out. So
how has it changed in those 5 years?
It's gotten a lot bigger, and it spreads out. You know, it used to be like 6th Street and just a little bit of area around there, and now it just keeps spreading farther and farther out and south of Congress. You know, on South Congress, it's like way down there, like, and here we're on the east side of 35, you know, so it's great, it's wonderful. I'm getting old, though, you know, I can't stay up late anymore. I had this big plan last night to go see one of my favorite bands at midnight, and the line looked like just a little bit too long for me, and I was like, oh man, I'm going home. So I just cashed in.
Cool. So do you have a favorite place in Austin to play, like a specific venue? Have you played, you know, a variety of them?
Yeah, I mean, I've played so many different places here, it's hard to say, you know. I guess when the temperature's right, it's really nice to play outside. So I played at Stubbs, and I really like their indoor venue as well. And I like Maggie Mae's, has like this atrium kind of room, garden room, it's really nice. But, I mean, where do you start?
Yeah.
Every place has a stage. So even some places that probably shouldn't.
Or just a street corner, even.
Exactly. But I'm not really the busking type. I'm not the type to force my music on people. I just present it, and hopefully, you know, they'll relate to it. I think the thing that I should have said earlier when we were talking about South by Southwest is that there's a really pleasant camaraderie of musicians here that I really like. I feel like it doesn't matter what genre you play in. You know, you show up here, you're interested, you're engaged, everybody kind of treats you fairly, everyone seems to be excited about being here and open to listening to new music. So for that, you know, I'm really thankful, you know. I like all kinds of music, not just the stuff that I make. Obviously, my music's pretty mellow, it's mostly acoustic-based, but I like all kinds of music, and I love the fact that South by Southwest brings everything here. You know, you can listen to world music and indie rock and, you know, electronic all in one day.
So. Wu-Tang's playing tonight, too.
Oh, are they? I'll be there.
I can tell.
Yeah.
You like Wu-Tang, right? So, talking a little bit more about your music, the new album you have coming out, what can you tell us about that?
It's called The Ones Who Wait. It comes out on April 26th on a record label from Nashville called Mono vs. Stereo. And it's kind of an accidental record. I started out trying to make an EP with a friend of mine from Philly, and he moved to New York kind of in the middle of the recording process, and then he opened a recording studio. He was looking for a studio partner, and I ended up partnering with him, and then we built the studio together. So we ended up building a commercial studio and recording the album at the same time. So now I have a new record and a studio to make my next record in.
It's a great way to test out the studio, right? To
see if it is. I'm the guinea pig artist, so I guess if it sounds really bad, it's my fault. I didn't design the room properly. So
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Yeah, I think you know, we hired some people to come in and do some pretty high tech readings on the room and make sure everything sounded good, and we're happy with it. So
you know, what's up for you for 2011 after South by?
Just a lot of touring. My new album coming out in April. I've got to hit the road, and so yeah, I'll be going all over the place. I mean, my CD release show, or I shouldn't say CD release anymore, I should say album release, is in Philly on May 7th, and New York the night before on May 6th, And then I go to the West Coast and go down the coast, back through Chicago, and come back home.
That's cool.
Yeah. Well, best of luck. Thank Safe you. Travels. Congrats on the new album, the
Thank
new
you.
Studio.
Thank you.
Hope it sounds good. I'm sure it does. But thanks again, Dennison.
Yeah.
And have a good show tonight, and we'll see you around.
Sounds
good. This is Tri-State Live at South by Southwest. PA represent, over and out.